I know it's weird to say this, but I've been thinking about it lately. Reminiscing about us in Vegas, drinking like we're famous. Man, those days were crazy. But your book ran out of pages, and now I wish I never waited to tell you. Out of all the moments in my life, the ones I got to share with you were probably my favorite. I know you're looking down on us. I'm missing you, bro. I hope you're proud of us. At least I know you made it home, and I know you're not alone. 'Cause now you're singing with the choir.
Thank you. Dear guest, please be seated, and as you do, please use this moment to check your mobile phones to ensure it is switched off or on silent mode. Distinguished guests, ladies, gentlemen, Pimpama State Secondary College staff, and of course my fellow students, my name is Deanna Stan, College Captain, and I welcome you to our 7th Annual Awards Night Ceremony. Before we begin our proceedings tonight, I would like to welcome Zara Matthews to give the Acknowledgement of Country.
Secondary College staff and students acknowledge the people of the Yugambeh language group, the traditional custodians of the land on which our school is built and our learning takes place. We pay our respect to the elders past, present and emerging, and recognise their connection to country and ways of sharing knowledge over thousands of years.
Thank you. Can I please ask everyone now to be upstanding for the national anthem?
Australians, all let us rejoice, for we are young and free. We've golden soil and wealth fertile. Our home is girt by sea. Of beauty rich and rare, in history's page let every stage advance Australia fair. In joyful strains then let us sing, advance Australia. the seas, we've boundless plains to share with hearts.
Tonight is one of the most important events on the college calendar because it is an occasion where we publicly recognize the success of our students. We acknowledge excellence in academic achievement and citizenship, and we aim to acknowledge those students who have shown unwavering commitment to upholding the college expectations and values and student leadership.
I would like to welcome the following special guests to our awards night ceremony. Mr. Cameron Cardwell, Division 3, Gold Coast City Councillor. Mrs. Susan Gostini, Community Engagement Manager for Gainsborough Greens. Ms. Sonia Black and Mr. Joshua Peters from Advanced Family Law. Mr. Marius Marks, Principal. Mr. Paul Finger, Deputy Principal. And Ms. Liz Lanford, Deputy Principal from Pimpama State School. Mr. Vic Graham, Principal, and Ms. Wendy Arts, Deputy Principal from Croomer River State School. Ms. Donna Gosling, Principal, and Mr. Stuart McKenzie, Deputy Principal from Pimpama State Primary College. Mr. Michael Crandon, State Member for Coomer, Mr. Stuart Robert, Federal Member for Fadden, and Mr. Barry McGrath, the President of the Lions Club Ormo, send their apologies and are unable to attend this evening.
Thank you also to all parents, teachers and students for your attendance this evening. My name is Natasha Symes, and together with my fellow student leaders, we will be your MCs throughout the ceremony. Please welcome Mr. John Thornbury to deliver the principal's address.
Thank you, everyone, and welcome here tonight. I've seen Zara perform that Welcome to Country a few times, and I continue to be moved by that performance. I challenge anyone not to be. So congratulations, Zara. I think it's a wonderful representation of a welcome to country. Distinguished guests, college staff, ladies, gentlemen, and students, welcome to our 2019 College Awards Night, the seventh such occasion in which we've gathered to celebrate the outstanding achievements of our students, your children. I'd like to begin, first of all, by thanking and acknowledging my colleagues from our local primary schools for your attendance tonight, and more importantly, for your ongoing support for our school, your willingness to work with us over many years now to build partnerships that prepares your students for the transition into secondary school, ensures the values and standards to which you hold your students, enables them to begin their secondary education in the best possible way. And it is perhaps a significant reason why so many of your former students will be on stage here tonight. 2019's been an incredible year in terms of achievements and milestones. Earlier this year, the Courier Mail listed the fastest growing schools in Queensland over the last 10 years between 2010 and 19. It's probably no surprise to anyone that we ranked number one with 600% growth in enrolment. A remarkable feat given that we've only been open for seven of those 10 years. As a result of this growth, we've been busy building. In January this year, we opened the $26 million and final stage of our master plan, which completes the $100 million investment into secondary education for the children in this community. Stage four finalised the construction of our state-of-the-art Performing Arts Centre, our student wellbeing hub, our creative industry centre with facilities for visual arts, hospitality and industrial technology. Apart from the buildings themselves, the resources and the technology in these buildings not only matches industry standards, but in many cases exceeds them. While our fabulous new buildings are the physical embodiment of the brilliant innovation influencing our students' education experience, we know that it's the people within the school that really lift us up and who create change and improve our lives. And tonight, it's about celebrating their achievement as well, which could not have happened without our supportive families. And in essence, then, tonight is really a celebration of our community. What students learn only means something if students continue to love learning, remain curious and strive for something better, ultimately find their place in the world. The future is created through honest, open reflections of our past. But if we want something better for the future, we have to create it. Our young people live in a different time, with opportunities that didn't exist when we were children. We'd be remiss if we allow our apprehensions to hold back their aspirations. And that is something that makes me proud of our teachers. Their openness to explore new ways of learning, to take risks, to encourage creativity through inquiry, curiosity, grit, reflection, and teamwork is something we should all be proud of. There's much less demand in the modern workforce for skills like memory and coordination, maintenance, management of material resources, and a greater need for analytical thinking, innovation, reasoning, curiosity, and complex problem solving. Knowledge is certainly necessary, but it's not sufficient anymore. Knowledge is a commodity. Anyone can acquire it. A few simple clicks and we can access more information than existed in all the world's libraries just a few decades ago. The competitive advantage for our students comes from having the skills that enables them to create knowledge, not just access existing knowledge. Examples of what innovation and modern learning can look like at Pimpama includes 8-year-8 students using virtual reality technology to build life-size community on the planet Mars. Our Year 9 students collecting plastic waste from their homes and around the school to recycle and manufacture into new injection molded and vacuum form products. Year 10 students refurbishing discarded walkers, wheelchairs and mobility scooters for struggling elderly people at local nursing homes. Year 11 design students working with the team who designed the Queen's Baton for the Commonwealth Games, and students working with Matt Stone Racing making gear shifters for their V8 supercars. Year 12 students designing augmented reality phone apps and games to help their fellow students learn science curriculum. We've also endeavoured to expose our students to real-world learning by bringing in authors, live performances to the school, participating in debating and Book Week. In 2019, we hosted 6 North Coast high schools for the Australian Business Week, which saw teams of Year 11 students working with industry mentors, bringing together a business plan, which they then pitched and marketed to judges. Our teachers then took that experience into our partner primary schools with the first ever ACE project, which had Year 5 students working along high school business students, developing business concepts and marketing plans. We launched eSport as an alternative to traditional sport on cluster days. In science, we rolled out 3 new subjects in engineering, psychology, and science in practice, meaning we are now the only school on the coast that offers all 7 science subjects in the curriculum. We were selected as the host school for the Griffith University STEM Cup, and we've established a partnership between the school and Jacobs Well Environmental Centre to pilot new senior biology programs using their facilities. We hosted the STEM Olympiad for Year 6 students. Around the school, teams of teachers brought new buildings, new curriculum, and new facilities to life. Students in visual arts worked with a professional artist to create an amazing and vibrant mural, which wraps around 2 of our buildings and incorporates visual elements of the creative arts and creative industries faculties. In performing arts, our students, some of whom are performing tonight, continue to go from strength to strength, taking out numerous awards in music, drama and dance at Bean Lee and Gold Coast of Stedfords. On the sporting fields, our sports academy grew to 250 students. We signed a partnership with Brisbane Roar Football Club, which sees our students being coached each week by Brisbane Roar coaches. We had a record number of students making district and regional teams, and 3 students competing at national level. We take the well-being of our students very seriously. I travel the state quite a lot, working with the school improvement unit and doing school reviews, so I can say that I have not seen any other school in Queensland who has gone out and built partnerships with external providers specifically to look after the well-being of students like this school. We have psychologists and youth workers from 7 different organisations in our school each day, and our unique partnership with Griffith University will mean an additional team of youth workers available in 2020 to support students and families in our community in crisis. I think one of the areas that I am most proud of is the broad curriculum offerings we have at the college that provides every student with the potential to turn aspirations and passion into viable post-schooling options. This year, our senior curriculum has grown from 38 different subject offerings to 56 general, applied and VET subject offerings. I won't say too much about the Year 12s because they're not all here tonight, and I'll certainly have the opportunity to speak more directly to them at their graduation next week, but it is worth noting, and I think it has been an absolute privilege watching this group of students mature from the 12 and 13 year olds that entered the school in 2014 and went on a journey similar to the one that's represented, well, was there, represented down here if you can see it. Obviously that memo didn't get to the right person. Where they're entering the school as young cubs, and this is part of our Pimpama Pride branding that we're very proud of and continue to launch throughout the year. And they journey through the school and experience all those different things in the arts and in the sciences and sporting fields and all those other different subject areas, leaving down the bottom there as a lion, part of the pride. We'll certainly miss our senior cohort this year, and I wish them all the very best in 2020. And I'd like to particularly thank and acknowledge our college captains, senior college captains, Deanna, Jaden, Destiny, and Stephanie. I think they were outstanding role models and ambassadors for our school. And I think each of these young people has an amazing future ahead of them. And I look forward to one day hearing about the great impact they're going to have on the world. The achievement of our Year 12 cohort is worth noting, and remind ourselves, it's a testament to the hard work and dedication both of the students themselves but also their teachers, with the support of their parents, and that very much is aligned to our school model motto of Together We Succeed. This is our third graduating cohort of students, and just like the previous graduates, our new graduating class have exceeded those that have gone before them. Among our senior cohort, we have over 40 of our current students who have already been offered university placements based on their senior results. And this includes 8 students who received the top range of offers in the STAR program that gave them direct entry into engineering, law and education degrees. In addition, we have 74 students who have either signed up or completed school-based apprenticeships and traineeships, ranging from certificate and diploma courses in business, hospitality, retail, tourism, early childhood, health, hairdressing, beauty, construction, automotive, and electrical. And for the third year in a row, 100% of our Year 12 students will achieve the Queensland Certificate of Education. They are, of course, the very last group of students to receive an OP. So this system has served Queensland well. So we have a new system of senior assessment and tertiary entrance for all students, and our Year 11s, the very first cohort to go through that. The changes were a consequence of a review conducted by the Australian Council for Education Research, and it is the most substantial education reform undertaken in Queensland for probably the last 30 years or so. The most significant change heralded in this system, of course, involves assessment, whereby students next year, our current Year 11s, will receive results in each subject based on a combination of in-school and external examinations. In 2020, our Year 11s, by this time of the year, will have already begun 3 weeks of external exams. Something to look forward to. And I think our Year 12s should breathe a mighty sigh of relief, because for quite some time, you guys were going to be the first group, and then at the last minute, the government delayed it until 2019. Lucky you. None of these experiences, none of these achievements that I've mentioned tonight could have happened without a teacher, and in many cases, the support of our teacher aid staff. These people gave up many hours of lunch times before school, after school, weekends, holidays, to coach, mentor, chaperone and chauffeur our students all over Southeast Queensland. And so on behalf of our community, I would like to thank our teaching staff for the enormous contributions that you make to all of our students, not only those that are here tonight, but all of those that are not. It would be fair to say that the students here tonight also had the love and support of amazing families. Together we succeed is more than just some words on a shirt pocket and a hat. This motto speaks to the importance of the partnership between students, families and teachers. And only when all members of that team work together does success occur. Rarely will it happen when one part of that team doesn't do their job. So I think it's important that tonight we recognise the families that are here with us. Thank you for entrusting us with your child's education, and thank you for your support for them, your encouragement, for prioritising their needs before your own, for the sacrifices you have made, and for the sacrifices you will continue to make. Finally, I'd like to thank the staff that put together this evening. It's been one of the good things about being in a big school. So I can just walk into nights like this and it's organised for me. And that's literally what happened, I can tell you. I'd like to, there were lots and lots of people involved, but I'd like to particularly thank one of the college deputy principals, Camilla White, and the business manager, Tracy Wallace, who were instrumental in getting this evening together. And I think they've done a wonderful job again. Thank you all so much for coming along tonight. Congratulations again to all of our award winners. To those of you who will be announced as student leaders tonight, well done, and I look forward to working with you next year. It's hard to believe that it's November already and the Christmas craziness is just around the corner. If I don't get to speak to you over the next few weeks, please have a fantastic Christmas and New Year. And to those students who are leaving the college at the end of the year and going elsewhere, I certainly hope the education you get at your new school is just as good as the one you've had here. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Mr. Thornberry. This evening's special performance is presented by the College Vocal Ensemble, Harmonix. Harmonix is a mixed vocal ensemble which incorporates both singing and movement to create a small production number for stage. Within the ensemble, students are given the opportunity to perform trios, duos, and solos to showcase their talents as vocalists.
Under the direction of Miss Alicia Shannon, the students' talents have been fostered throughout the year and were showcased at the Beanley Music of Stedford, with the group being awarded for second for both the musical theatre and jazz section, as well as the own choice section. Along with this, they won the novelty section in first place. This performance is a two-part arrangement of the power ballad from the movie musical, The Greatest Showman. Please welcome Miss Shannon and Harmonix with their rendition of This Is Me.
What a wonderful performance from the Harmonics Ensemble. Thank you, students and teachers, for the time and commitment you've made in this busy time of the year to perform for us here tonight.
To commence our official awards this evening, I now invite Pimpama State Primary College Principal, Ms. Donna Gosling, Pimpama State School Principal, Mr. Marius Hicks, and Junior School Deputy Principal, Mrs. Celia Norling, to the stage to present the Future Year 7 Scholarship Awards.
It gives me great pleasure to announce our four value scholarship recipients for 2020. These scholarships are open to Future Year 7 students who have outstanding attitude, effort, behaviour and attendance in both schooling and community endeavours. Each scholarship is centred on our core college values, represented in our four college houses, and is valued at $500 in total. For respect, courage and commitment, the Nancy Wake Scholarship recipient is Lachlan Wilson from Pimpama State Primary College. For the values of compassion and good citizenship, the John Flynn recipient is Sida Lang from Pimpama State Primary College. And for community service and leadership, the Weary Dunlop Scholarship recipient is Zali Crow from Pimpama State School. And
And for integrity, initiative and perseverance, the Mary Gilmore Scholarship recipient is Olivia Scott, also from Pimpama State School. Thank you, Ms. Gosling, Mr. Marks, and Mrs. Norling, and congratulations to our future students. I'm sure that your time at Pimpama State Secondary College will be successful.
Our next order of business tonight is the presentation of subject awards. Subject awards are awarded to the student who has been recognised as the top performing student for each subject in their year level. These awards will be presented by the heads of department for each faculty. I welcome the English head of department, Ms. Kiralee Gillies, and the mathematics head of department, Mrs. Kelly Turner, to the stage to present their faculty awards. Can I please ask that you hold your applause to the end?
The award recipients for the English faculty are Year 7 Canon English, Erin Crichton. Year 8 Canon English, Gabrielle McFarlane. Year 9 Canon English, Sophie Doherty. Year 7 English, Tiana Capone, who will not be attending tonight. Year 8 English, Natasha Symes. Year 9 English, Lucy Barrett. Year 10 English, Haley Seath. Year 11 English, Liam Armstrong. Year 12 English, Paige Tunstall. Year 10 Essential English, Arnold Putra. Year 11 Essential English, Ethan Kitt, who will not be attending tonight. Year 12 English Communication, Danielle Marshall. And Year 11 Literature, Brianna Florian. Please congratulate these students.
The award recipients for the mathematics faculty are Year 7 STEMMED Maths, Catherine Collins. Year 8 STEMS Maths, Annika Marinick. Year 9 STEMS Maths, Jason Sinclair. Year 7 Mathematics, Jesse Wallace. Year 8 Mathematics, Ryan Wang, who unfortunately is unable to attend tonight. Year 9 Mathematics, Jelani Treen. Year 10 Essential Mathematics, Cody Latham, who is also unable to attend tonight. Year 11 Essential Mathematics, Miranda McDean. Year 10 General Mathematics, Michaela Hamilton. Year 11 General Mathematics, Mitch Campbell. Year 10 Mathematics Methods, Indiana DeRota. Year 11 Mathematics Methods and Specialist Mathematics, Liam Armstrong. Year 12 Pre-Vocational Mathematics, Matthias Mayer. Year 12 Mathematics A, Chloe Frost. Year 12 Mathematics B and Mathematics C, Tori Baker. Please congratulate these students.
I welcome the Humanities and Low Head of Department, Ms. Renee Larkin, and the Science Head of Department, Ms. Nadia Graham, to the stage to present their faculty awards. Can I please ask that you hold your applause until the end? The award recipients for the Humanities faculty are Year 7, Canon Humanities, Erin Crichton. Year 8, Canon Humanities, Gabrielle McFarlane. Year 9, Canon Humanities, Stephanie Stan. Year 7 Humanities, Talitha Percival. Year 8 Humanities, Tima White, who will not be attending tonight. Year 9 Humanities, Lucy Barrett. Year 10 Modern History, Claudia Sweet. Year 11, Modern History, Vanessa Boychenko. Year 12, Modern History, Lachlan Cook. Year 12, Modern History, Aaron Woodcock. Year 9, Ancient History, Riley Caswell. Year 10, Cultural History, Jesse Wyke. Year 10, Social Science, Lily Cresswell. Year 7 Chinese, Brianna Corcoran. Year 8 Chinese, Ryan Wang, who will not be attending tonight. Year 9 Chinese, Lucy Barrett. Year 10 Chinese, Jason Sinclair. Year 11 Chinese, Liam Armstrong. And year 12 Chinese, Cheyenne Baker. Please congratulate these students.
The award recipients for the science faculty are Year 7 Science, Sarah McFarlane. Year 8 Science, Ryan Wang, who is unfortunately unable to attend tonight. Year 9 Science, Sienna Intel. Year 7 STEM Science, Catherine Collins. Year 8 STEM Science, Gabrielle McFarlane. Year 9 STEM Science, Jason Sinclair. Year 10 Science and Practice, Chelsea Hyatt. Year 11 Science and Practice, Lanisha Rapati. Year 10 Biology, Hannah Corby. Year 11 Biology, Lily Halloran. Year 12 Biology and Marine Science, Cheyenne Baker. Year 10 Engineering, Joshua Walsh. Year 11 Engineering, Lachlan Symes. Year 11 Marine Science, Jade Osborne. Year 10 Physics, Damon Orr. Year 11 Physics and Chemistry, Liam Armstrong. Year 12 Physics, Stephanie D'Elia. Year 10 Chemistry and Marine Science, Indiana DeRota. Year 12 Chemistry, Max Warner. Year 11 Psychology, Lily Halloran. Please congratulate these students.
I welcome the Creative Arts Head of Department, Ms. Mindy Mewing, and the Performing Arts Head of Department, Ms. Rebecca Costello, to the stage to present their faculty awards. Can I please ask that you hold your applause until the end? The award recipients for the Creative Arts faculty are Year 7, Designing Futures, Lucius Eminger. Year 8, Designing Futures, Chaz Ward. Year 9, Digital Media and Design, Ashley Truloff. Year 10, Digital Media and Design, Francis Torres. Year 12, Digital Design, Eli Eminger. Year 10, Fashion, Alexandra Allam. Year 11, Fashion, Morgan Strom. Year 12, Fashion, Andrew Sejnovic. Year 11, Film, Television and New Media, Carl Gribben. Year 11, Practical Art and Design and Digital Design, Paige Adams. Year 12, Practical Art and Design, John Agno. Year 9, Visual Arts, Tali Middling. Year 10, Visual Arts, Molly Haste, who will not be attending tonight. Year 11, Visual Arts, Miranda McDean. And Year 12, Visual Arts, Erin Woodcock. Please congratulate these students.
The award recipients for the Performing Arts faculty are Year 7 Aspiring Performers Academy Drama, Jazzy Brassel. Year 8 Aspiring Performers Academy Drama, Madison Dixon. Year 9 Aspiring Performers Academy Drama, Scylla Beetham Smith. Year 10, Aspiring Performers Academy Drama, Lily Creswell. Year 7, Aspiring Performers Academy Music, Mia McKinger. Year 8, Aspiring Performers Academy Music, Michael Abraham, who was unable to attend tonight. Year 9, Aspiring Performers Academy Music, Sienna Intel. Year 7, Aspiring Performers Academy Drama, Diana Thompson. Year 8 Aspiring Performers Academy Dance, Lily Crabb. Year 9 Aspiring Performers Academy Dance, Zara Matthew. Year 10 Aspiring Performers Academy Dance, Beyonce Bobby. Year 9 Dance, Indiana Chauba. Year 10 Dance, Jolene Walker. Year 11 Dance and Dance in Practice, Acacia German. Year 12 Dance, Ariana Shepherd. Year 9 Drama, Caleb Martin. Year 10 Drama, Jesse Wyke. Year 12 Drama, Lauren Ledley. Year 11 Drama in Practice, Kyle Gribben. Year 9 Music, Stephanie Stan. Year 10 Music, Asha Cosgrove. Year 11 Music, Dylan Thomas. Year 12 Music, Brianna Huth. Year 10 Music Industry, Jackson Thompson. Please congratulate these students.
I welcome the Business Enterprise Head of Department, Ms. Joanna Humphreys, and the Creative Industries Head of Department, Mr. Dwayne Cicluna, to the stage to present their faculty awards. Can I please ask that you hold your applause until the end? The award recipients for the Business Enterprise faculty are Year 8 Business, Noah Dada. Year 9 Business, Scylla Beetham-Smith. Year 10 Business, Georgia Scott. Year 11 Business Management, Samar Bajwa. Year 12 Business Management, Ariana Shepherd. Year 9 Food Studies, Emily Gunter. Year 10 Hospitality, Francis Torres. Year 10 Legal Studies, Georgia Scott. Year 11 Legal Studies, Jerry Managazzo. Year 12 Legal Studies, Annalise Rowe. And Year 11 Tourism, Yasmin Carter. Please congratulate these students.
The award recipients for the Creative Industries faculty are Year 7 Co-Design Izzy Matassa, Year 8 Co-Design Isabella Embleton, Year 10 Design Daniel Collins, Year 11 Design Jennifer Osborne, Year 10 Digital Solutions, Asha Cosgrove. Year 11 Digital Solutions, Bailey Jackson. Year 10 Fix Ed, Chelsea Hyatt. Year 12 Graphics, Deanna Stan. Year 8 Industrial Technology and Design, Kiara Florian. Year 9 Industrial Technology and Design, Stephanie Stan. Year 9 Industrial Technology Skills, Kyle Butcher. Year 10 Industrial Technology Skills, Ashton Paul. Year 11, Industrial Technology Skills, Matthew Tiato. Year 12, Industrial Technology Skills, Alyssa Milton. Year 12, Information Technology Systems, Eli Eminger. Year 9, Playmakers, Aaron Dark, who was unable to attend tonight. Year 7, STEM Design, Catherine Collins. Year 8 STEM Design, Vin Nguyen Pakabut. Year 12 Technology Studies, Sheldon Keel. Please congratulate these students.
I welcome the two Health and Physical Education Head of Departments, Ms. Elise Brown and Mrs. Chanel Morrison, and the Inclusive Practices Deputy Principal to the stage to present their faculty awards. Can I please ask that you hold your applause until the end? The award recipients for the Health and Physical Education faculty are Year 7 Elite Athlete Development, Cassie Wilson. Year 8 Elite Athlete Development, Harlem Matiti. Year 9 Elite Athlete Development, Emily Gunter. Year 10 Elite Athlete Development, Zach Galea. Year 7 Health and Physical Education, Lex Keogh. Year 8, Health and Physical Education, Sarah Thornhill. Year 9, Health and Physical Education, Lucy Barrett. Year 10, Health, Hayley Seath. Year 11, Health, Miranda McDean. Year 12, Health, Paige Tunstall. Year 10, Physical Education, Faith Ropati. Year 11, Physical Education, Brandon Rakhavan. And Year 12, Physical Education, Ayla Couples. Please congratulate these students.
The award recipients for inclusive practices are Year 7 ASDAN, Peyton Luwaki. Year 8 ASDAN, Anna McCarthy. Year 9 ASDAN, Phoebe Armadillo. Year 10 ASDAN, Christopher Newman. Year 11, Queensland Certificate Individual Achievement, Tatiana Wilden. Year 12, Queensland Certificate Individual Achievement, Lachlan Krimick. Year 12, Queensland Certificate Individual Achievement, Jessica Patterson. Year 12, Queensland Certificate Individual Achievement, Simu Soy Malilaga. Please congratulate these students.
The Academic Excellence Awards are awarded to students for outstanding academic performance across all subjects. Students must finish the academic year with a grade point average of 4.5 or better. Achieving a grade point average at this level means that a majority of a student's results across all report cards issued are of an excellent standard. I welcome our sub-school deputies, Mrs. Celia Norling, Deputy Principal for Junior School, Ms. Anna Aldridge, Deputy Principal for Middle School, and Mr. Stephen Ziske, Deputy Principal for Senior School, to present the Academic Excellence Awards this evening.
The Academic Excellence Awards for Year 7 are Kaylee Baxter, Catherine Collins, Erin Crichton, Lisa H, Brianna Keep, Charlotte Kelly. Sarah McFarlane. And Emily McKay. Please congratulate the Year 7 Academic Award recipients. The Academic Excellence Awards for Year 8 are Lily Crabb, Taylor Dempsey, Gabrielle McFarlane, Annika Marinick, Stephanie Newman, Natasha Symes, Ryan Wang, who could not be present today, and Callum Westhorpe. Please congratulate the Year 8 Academic Award recipients.
The Academic Excellence Awards for Year 9 are Priscilla Alang, Lucy Barrett, Scylla Beetham-Smith, Saga Bell, who could not be with us tonight, Kira Clark, who could not attend tonight, Madeline Crabb. Georgia Crichton. Indiana Chorba. Jordan Doty. Haley Franklin. Sienna Intel. Adrian Mabbitt and Mitch Moss, who could not be here tonight. Evan Scrimger. Jason Sinclair. Stephanie Stan. Aaliyah Strafford, who could not be in attendance tonight. Jelani Treen. Aaliyah Walsh. Please congratulate the Year 9 Academic Excellence Awards.
The Academic Excellence Awards for Year 10 are Hannah Corby. Lily Cresswell. Isabel Cummins. Indiana DeRota. Christopher Newman. Georgia Scott. Grace Tucker. Joshua Walsh. Please congratulate our Year 10 Academic Excellence Award recipients. The Year 11 Academic Excellence Awards are Paige Adams, Liam Armstrong, Vanessa Boychenko, Brianna Florian, Samuel Kickbush, please congratulate our Year 11 Academic Award recipients. The Year 12 Academic Excellence Awards are Grace Buck, Ramaya Siumanufanai, Ariana Shepherd, Deanna Stan, Paige Tunstall, please congratulate our Year 12 Academic Award recipients.
The Principal Awards is issued to students who demonstrate excellent effort and behaviour in class and who show exceptional commitment to college expectations at all times. To receive this award, students have to consistently demonstrate excellent standards for both effort and behaviour across all subject areas throughout the year.
Students who are previously acknowledged as academic award recipients also are issued with the Principal's Award. It goes without saying, the exceptional results that are achieved by academic award recipients only come through equally exceptional commitment to study and consistently high standards of classroom effort and behaviour. The following recipients of the Principal's Award demonstrate an equally excellent commitment to their studies.
I welcome Mr. John Thornberry, College Principal, to the stage to present the Principal's Awards. Our Year 7 Principal's Award recipients are Caden Ash, Kaylee Baxter, Sorry. Catherine Collins. Brianna Corcoran. Aaron Creighton. Xander Differ. Kia Gretsch. Davy Hawke. Lisa Ho. Brianna Keep. Charlotte Kelly. Emily McKay. Sugar Roa White. Lucy Sanders. Sophie Shipton. Diana Thompson. Caitlin Tiato. Ethan Waddle. Ruby Young. Please congratulate these students.
Our Year 8 Principals Award recipients are Kiana McNally, Taylor Dempsey, Isabella Embleton, Kiara Florian, Laura Henderson, Rachna Liang, Gabrielle McFarlane, Annika Marinick, Madeline Minigazzo, Stephanie Newman, Vin Nguyen Pakabut, Alyssa Scottson, Natasha Symes, Sarah Thornhill, Ryan Meng, who could not make it tonight, Chaz Ward, Sherry Jones, please congratulate these students.
Our Year 9 Principal Award recipients are Priscilla Olang, Lucy Barrett, Scylla Beetham-Smith, Kimora Beckett, who couldn't be here tonight, and Kira Clark, who couldn't be here tonight, Eloise Cousins, Georgia Creighton, Jordan Doherty, Haley Franklin, Sienna Intel, Samantha Maguire, Mitch Moss, who couldn't be here today, Jason Sinclair, Lisa Sinclair, Stephanie Stan, Aaliyah Strafford, who couldn't be here tonight, Jelani Treen, Lily J. Wilson, Tiana Wolstenholm, please congratulate these students. Our Year 10 Principal Award recipients are Hannah Corby, Lily Creswell, Isabel Cummins, Indiana DeRoda, Trinity Jefferson, Isabella Canitz, Georgia Scott, T-Pay Treen, Grace Tucker, Michaela Hamilton, please congratulate these students.
Year 11 Principal Award recipients are Paige Adams, Liam Armstrong, Samar Bajwa, Vanessa Boychenko, Yasmin Carter, Brianna Florian, Isabella Georgakopoulos, Kaylin Jackson, Miranda McDean, Please congratulate these students. Year 12 Principal Award recipients are Stephanie Delia, Cheyenne Baker, Grace Buck, Alana Johnson, who couldn't make it tonight, Samuel McKenzie, Annalise Rowe, Ramaya Sue Manafangai, Ariana Shepherd, Deanna Stan, Paige Tunstall, Max Warner, please congratulate these students.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now delighted to announce the recipients of the special awards. These awards acknowledge students achieve across various disciplines, including sports and academic excellence, including extracurricular activities, continual representation of the college values and visions. These awards will be presented by our special guests, head of departments, principals and deputy principals. The recipients of these awards have not been informed. Their only exception is the Junior and Senior Sportsperson of the Year Award, which was announced at our College Sports Awards evening. To commence our special awards, I wish to acknowledge the achievements of the Sports Award recipients who will be joining us on stage.
The Junior Sportsman for 2019 was awarded to Brayden Wong. Brayden is proving to be quite the all-rounder, achieving age champion in cross-country and athletics, as well as making the district cross-country, swimming, and touch football. Brayden is an integral member and leader within the College Sport Academy's touch football team. Brayden was also a member of the Gold Coast Academy of Sport Rugby League Future Stars program, and involved within the school's Future Stars program. We look forward to watching Brayden continue to go from strength to strength in the coming years. The Junior Sportswoman for 2019 was awarded to Maisie Walsh. Maisie is a dedicated and passionate swimmer who trains most days, putting in the grueling hours in the pool. This year, she represented Gold Coast at the State Swimming Championship and was selected in the Queensland State Swimming Team. Her hard work continues to pay off, and we wish her every success for the future. The Senior Sportsman for 2019 was awarded to Demetrius Williams. Demetrius is an exceptional sportsman who was selected in the district athletics team and made the Rugby Union Queensland State team. Demetrius is a respectful and hardworking student and athlete, and we are very proud of his outstanding achievements this year. We look forward to watching Demetrius go and develop into a leader within the sport academy and school. The Senior Sportswoman for 2019 was awarded to Brooklyn Utber. Brooklyn has proven her ability in athletics time and time again. This year, she has backed up her titles in the javelin event at a representative level, being undefeated in her age group. She was at the college athletics age champion and convincingly won her javelin event at the South Coast Regionals event. She has been selected in the Queensland State team to compete in nationals in December. We wish her all the best in the future. Congratulations to all the sports award recipients.
I welcome Community Engagement Manager for Gainsborough Greens, Mrs. Suzanne Gustini, and the Performing Arts Head of Department, Mrs. Rebecca Costello, to the stage to present the Performing Arts Award. This prestigious perpetual award is presented to the Pimpama State Secondary College student who has demonstrated outstanding effort and achievement throughout the year in performing arts. The Performing Arts Student of the Year is Ariana Shepherd. Ariana is a Year 12 student who embodies our ideals of a performing arts student here at Pimpama. Ariana is a highly dedicated student who continually challenges herself and strives for excellence in her academic studies in dance and has done us proud as dance captain for the dance troupe. Ariana is an understanding and supportive leader who inspires her peers to strive for excellence in rehearsals and performance. She works cooperatively and creatively with both her peers and teachers and is always the first to gladly give up her time to help a fellow student master a routine in rehearsal, provide guidance at a dance competition, or provide solutions to choreographic dilemmas when a routine is needed to be reblocked. It is no wonder our younger members of dance troupe aspire to be a dance captain like her. Ariana has always approached her academic studies with a determination and discipline that is to be admired. Due to her unwavering dedication to her studies, Ariana is the first dance student at the college to gain the highest possible grade in dance for her ability to write sophisticated responses to dance works, demonstrate commanding technical and expressive skills in performance, and demonstrate an outstanding ability to choreograph moving dance works. It has been an honor and pleasure to watch Ariana go from strength to strength academically and as a dancer, and to have watched her grow into a strong and respected leader. Congratulations, Ariana.
I welcome the Deputy Principal of Middle School, Ms. Anna Aldridge, and the Humanities Head of Department, Ms. Renee Larkin, to the stage to present the Citizenship and Innovation Award. This new award is presented to the student who has demonstrated a comprehensive understanding of the community, designed an innovative way to improve an area of the Gold Coast, and has demonstrated outstanding effort and achievement. The Citizenship and Innovation Student of the Year is Jesse James McKenzie. Jesse James is a Year 7 student who demonstrates all of the qualities of an exemplary Pimpama State Secondary College student. He is highly dedicated to producing quality results and continually strives for excellence throughout his studies. Jesse James is an inquisitive and independent learner who is able to work cooperatively with peers and teachers alike. He has proven his dedication within the community through his involvement in several extracurricular activities and applying his knowledge to the real world through the idea of a youth centre. Jesse James is a role model for all students and is a worthy recipient of this award. Congratulations, Jesse James.
I welcome the Deputy Principal of Senior School, Mr. Stephen Ziske, and Head of Department for Senior School, Mr. Tony Burns, to the stage to present the next awards. The Entrepreneur and Innovation Award recognises a student who has demonstrated innovative thinking and empathetic design to improve social cohesion and well-being within our local community. The Entrepreneur and Innovator of the Year is Zach Atkinson. Zach has demonstrated these capabilities throughout his senior curriculum in technology studies. He has used his creativity, original thought, and social entrepreneur skills to tackle the rising issues of household waste generation by connecting our local community with the avenues of recycling their discarded electronic goods. Congratulations, Zach.
I welcome to the stage Ms. Sonia Black and Mr. Joshua Peters from Advanced Family Law to the stage. Advanced Family Law have kindly sponsored this award for 2019. This external study award recognizes the senior secondary student who has excelled in the field of vocational education and training. Not only would the student demonstrate academic excellence in their chosen VET subject, but they would also show exemplary attitude, professionalism, and work ethic in the workplace whilst completing a school-based apprenticeship or traineeship. The External Studies Award recipient for 2019 is Jessica Patterson. Jessica started out studying hospitality in year 10 and 11. She quickly showed a keen interest in pursuing this career pathway further, and it wasn't long before Jessica secured a school-based traineeship studying a Certificate 3 in hospitality at Key Street Cafe in Sanctuary Cove. Throughout her training and work placement, Jessica continually impressed both her employer and her RTO trainer with her professionalism, work ethic, and perseverance through a challenging course. So much so that she secured a post-secondary employment with the company hiring her prior to completing the Certificate 3 course. Congratulations, Jessica.
This year, we have been privileged to have the Lions Club of Ormo sponsor a Personal Development and Achievement Award. This award aims to recognize an exceptional student who has consistently displayed a determination to improve themselves and to serve the school community. This year, we have two worthy recipients for this award. The Lions Club Award recipients for 2019 are Natasha Symes and Tobias Hughes. Natasha Symes is an exemplary student who is self-motivated and has demonstrated our college values over the past 2 years as a junior secondary student. She is a compassionate person who considers the needs of our school community before her own. As junior secondary captain, Natasha has excelled in her leadership capabilities, using her initiative and contributing to the seamless running of key school events, including principal tours, meet and greets, and reading the acknowledgement of country at year-level assemblies. She participates in extracurricular activities such as harmonics and has been recognized over the past 2 years for her 100% attendance rate, spirit and integrity awards, as well as an overall excellent rating for behavior and effort. Congratulations, Natasha. Tobias Hughes is also an exemplary student who offers his time tirelessly to support the successful running of school events and activities. He is a valued role model of the Elite Athletic Development Team and has received Student of the Week awards for being an encouraging member of his classes. Tobias, with his cheerful demeanor, contributes to all aspects of school life, including the successful running of school assemblies, principal tours, and meet and greets. In his role as junior secondary vice captain, he demonstrates excellent work ethic with consistently both very good and excellent effort and behavior, as well as 100% attendance. Congratulations, Tobias.
I welcome Division 3 Councillor Mr. Cameron Caldwell to the stage to present the Community Award. Each year, Councillor Cameron Caldwell sponsors the Community Award. This award recognises a Year 8 student who contributes positively to both the school and the wider community. The Councillor Cameron Caldwell Community Award recipient is Gabriel Wilkinson. Gabriel Wilkinson is a model student that displays the values of Pimpama State Secondary College. He is a junior school leader as part of the wellbeing team and regularly participates in meetings to assist with the organisation of events, helping with school assemblies, and also behind the scenes at awards nights. Gabriel is a member of both the Elite Athlete Development Program and the STEM D class, and throughout the year he has consistently received excellent results in his schooling and for effort and behaviour across all subjects. Gabriel maintains a positive disposition and approaches tasks willingly. He is an excellent role model for other students and a model student. Congratulations, Gabriel.
I welcome to the stage Junior School Head of Department, Mr. Joshua Eubank, to the stage to present the next two awards. Throughout our brief history, we have enjoyed great support from the member of Coomera, Michael Crandon. Michael Crandon continues to show an active interest in the school and has represented our interest at ministerial level on several occasions. Whether it is working to improve our bus services or getting new buildings, he is dedicated and committed to the success of our school. It is appropriate that the Mr. Crandon has sponsored the Michael Crandon Dedication Award and Commitment Award. The award recognises a male and a female student from Year 7 who shows ongoing commitment and excellence in representing the college values in the school. The Michael Crandon Dedication Commitment Award recipients for 2019 are Oshiala Dilks and Lyric Arthur. Oceana is a studious member of the STEM Academy who always strives for excellence. Her effervescent personality is infectious and her creative ideas are to be commended. She shows leadership qualities in group work activities and has a commendable work ethic. She is diligent and attentive in class and is always helpful to her teachers and classmates. She contributes to her classes magnificently and has proven to be an excellent role model for her peers. Oceana is a member of the theatre company and always puts 110% effort into her work. She is the epitome of a student who is resilient and hardworking in the face of adversity. Not only is she a strong team member, but she ensures that others feel good about themselves by offering praise and encouragement. A strong performer, Oceana allows others the opportunity to stand out and is happy to take on smaller roles to allow others to grow. She is a positive influence on all our members of the school. Lyric is a polite and well-mannered student who strives to perform to the best of his ability. His work ethic and academic achievement have consistently improved each term. He is respectful to his teachers and fellow peers. He is diligent when completing set tasks and ensures that he clarifies questions which benefits his learning as well as his peers. He is an exceptional role model. Congratulations, Oceana and Lyric.
The federal member for Fadden, Mr. Stuart Robert MP, has been kind enough to offer a leadership award to the college for the student who demonstrates positive leadership within the school environment. This year's award recipient for the Stuart Robert Leadership Award is Destiny Bennett.
No crying.
Destiny is a caring and compassionate member of the school community. And in her role as vice captain, she has excelled in advocating the needs of a student body at all levels within the school community. Destiny has a strong sense of fairness and integrity and always approaches her leadership roles with these values, even when faced with adversity. She is an honest, thoughtful, loyal, open-minded, and passionate person and approaches every task with the willingness and determination to follow through and stay true to her convictions. Destiny is an effective communicator and is capable of engaging with a diverse range of people and will go above and beyond her duties to ensure the right outcome is reached. These attributes have made Destiny one of the best school leaders we've had at Pimpama State Secondary College. And we're proud of her achievements and the legacy she left will leave for future school captains. We wish her well in her future endeavors. Congratulations, Destiny.
I welcome Deputy Principal Mrs. Camilla White to the stage to present the Year 10 and Year 12 Long 10 Awards. The ADF Longtan Leadership and Teamwork Awards, started in 2006, aim to recognise students who demonstrate leadership and teamwork within both the school and the local community. The awards are an important initiative by the Australian Government in conjunction with the Australian Defence Force, designed to encourage senior students, tomorrow's leaders, to actively participate in the life of their schools and local communities. The Longtan Year 10 Award recipient is Nigel Myers. Nigel has been a student of Pimpama State Secondary College since 2016 and is our current middle school captain. He upholds the college values of perseverance, respect, integrity, dedication and empathy in all facets of his life. Nigel has represented our college with pride and determination through leadership meetings, principals tours, organising college-wide events such as Bullying No Way Day, Are You OK Day, Queensland Mental Health Week, World Teachers Day and other similar events to promote college culture. Recently, Nigel was presented with a certificate from the Mayor of the Gold Coast, Tom Tate, for his representation of Pimpama State Secondary College at the Gold Coast Junior Council. Nigel is an exemplary leader who displays many positive attributes through his leadership. He uses his initiative and he is personable, helpful, and considerate. He approaches his peers with understanding, compassion, humility, open-mindedness, willingness, and positivity. He is a worthy winner of the 2019 Longtan Award.
The Longtan Year 12 Award recipient is Deanna Stan. Deanna has been a student of Pimpama State Secondary College since 2017 and has graduated as a part of the 2019 Year 12 cohort. She has always maintained exceptional standards and has remained committed to upholding the college values of perseverance, courage, respect, integrity, and compassion. In her role as college captain, Deanna has represented our college with pride and determination through leadership meetings, enrollment evenings, Excellence Academy evenings, public events such as Anzac ceremonies, and the 2019 Australian Business Week launch. Most recently, Deanna represented Pimpama by attending an Education Week event hosted by the Premier and Education Minister. Deanna has been involved with the leadership mentoring programs run by both the Queensland Academy and Bond University. As a member of the Wellbeing Team Committee, Deanna has helped to organise events for Are You OK Day, Bullying No Way Day, Mental Health Week, Silly Sock Day, and Wear It Purple Day. Helping to organise these events has shown Deanna to be a leader to help out a wide variety of students at our college. Deanna is an exemplary leader who displays many positive attributes through her leadership, including understanding, compassion, persistence, humility, open-mindedness, willingness, positivity, passion, and courage. She is a worthy winner of the 2019 Longtan Award. Congratulations, Nigel and Deanna.
For over a quarter of a century, the Caltech's All-Rounder Award has earned a reputation for being one of Australia's most respected secondary education recognition programs. It has been presented to thousands of students, acknowledging their all-round contributions to their schools and communities. The Caltech's All-Rounder Award for 2019 goes to Ramaya Sumanafungai. Ramaya has achieved academic success in her time at the college and has received a number of accolades. These include academic awards in years 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12, demonstrating consistently high achievement across all subjects. Ramaya also received the Health and Physical Education Award in both year 9 and year 10, and she was runner-up for the Physical Education Award this year. Ramaya has also maintained excellent effort and behaviour in every subject since enrolling in the college in 2014. Ramaya has been a strong ambassador for the college and has represented Pimpama State Secondary College in a number of activities, including sports carnivals, cluster sport netball in year 8 and year 9, business market day and Chinese market stalls. Ramaya has also shown a strong commitment to the wider music and arts program in her time at the college and has participated in the Logan Leah Stedford and the Performing Arts Gala as part of the guitar ensemble. In addition to this, she has also volunteered her time as part of the music and tech crew. Ramaya has been a strong leader of the school. In her role as netball captain for the Vicky Wilson team, she has shown exemplary sportsmanship by consistently encouraging, supporting, and motivating others. She also assisted with the team organisation. Congratulations, Ramaya.
The final awards this evening is the prestigious awards for junior and senior college ducks. These awards recognize the student in year 9 and 12 who has received the highest academic achievement across the curriculum. I welcome Mr. John Thornberry, college principal, to the stage to announce and present the junior college ducks and senior college ducks awards. The junior ducks for 2019 is Celia Betham Smith. And the senior ducks for 2019 is Ariana Shepherd.
To finalise the special awards for this evening, it gives me great pleasure to announce our 2020 College Student Leaders. I welcome Mr. John Thornberry, Principal, and Middle School Head of Department, Ms. Danielle Dreiber, to the stage to present the captains with their blazers. The leadership process included a nomination, shortlisting, speeches in front of the sub-school, and then an interview. I would like to congratulate these students for being recognised by both staff and their peers. I know they will represent themselves, their families, and the college proudly throughout 2020. I am confident they will make a significant contribution to the college. The junior school captains for 2020 are Oceana Dykes and Brianna Keep. And the junior school vice captains are Xander Differ and Kelsey McNally. Our middle school captains for 2020 are Tony Grover and Anika Kraft. And our middle school vice captains are Lucy Williams and Bo Googe. I'm sorry. The final leadership positions to be announced tonight are the senior captains, who will be known as the college captains. I think they will make a significant contribution to the culture of our school, be excellent role models, and bring a student voice to decisions regarding school direction. Our college captains for 2020 are Thomas Laban and Jennifer Osborne. And our college vice captains are Brianna Florian and Morgan Strom. Congratulations, 2020 student leaders. To conclude this evening, I will now present the vote of thanks. Special guests, ladies and gentlemen, and fellow students, we now come an end to the evening and draw the curtain close to our 7th annual award ceremony. Congratulations to all our award recipients this evening. Your recognition has been well deserved. I hope you continue to achieve success in the coming years. Round of applause. A special guest goes to our community guests for your attendance this evening and for your continuous support to our students and our school. I would also like to acknowledge the presence here tonight of our local school principals and deputy principals. I know that like you, you've also enjoyed the performances tonight. Thank you must go to the students who gave up many hours to perform together, and in particular the students. We also appreciate the efforts all the teachers who have helped out tonight, backstage and in front of the stage. I know Mr. Thornberry greatly appreciates the job you have put in tonight to making the event successful. Congratulations to the 2020 school leaders. You have earned your positions by being recognised by your peers and your teachers. I know you will do great work next year and add value to the already great things happening in the college. On behalf of the college community, I would also like to thank our parents and our caregivers. We appreciate your support this evening in coming along and joining us in celebrating the achievements of your children. Students rarely achieve success without the assistance of the supportive parents, so you all deserve to be recognised and congratulated for your efforts. Finally, I would like to recognise the teachers. It's not an easy job putting up with the students all day, but your work tirelessly in getting engaging and interesting lessons together, supporting us on our learning journey, taking time to coach and rehearse with us, taking us on camps and excursions, listening us to when we feel down, and congratulating on us on what we do well is really commended. We don't often tell you how much we appreciate what you do for us, so I would like tonight to recognise that and ask that we all give you a round of applause. To end our evening, please enjoy a performance from Dance Troupe.
Tonight, I'm gonna have myself a real good time. Feel alive, and the world I'm turning inside out. Yeah. I'm floating around in ecstasy, so
don't stop me now. star, leaping through the sky like a tiger, defying the laws of gravity. I'm a racing car, passing by like Lady Godiva. I'm gonna go, 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 there's no stopping me. I'm burning through the sky, yeah. 200 degrees, just while they call me Mr. Fahrenheit. I'm traveling at the speed of light. I wanna make a supersonic woman.
Our award ceremony for this evening. Please have a safe journey home, and if we don't see you before the end of the year, I hope you will have a great Christmas and a happy new year. Stay safe and have a good night.
It's crazy when the thing you love the most is the detriment. Let that sink in. Think again when the hand you wanna hold is a weapon in nothing but skin. Oh, cause I keep digging myself down deeper. I won't stop till I get where you are. I keep running, I keep running, I keep running. They say I may be making a mistake. I would have followed all the way, no matter how far. Graveyard.